low.
Good morning, faculty and staff.
Good morning, students.
How are you today? That's good. Good morning, Christine.
Good morning, Sir Ferdy. How are you today?
I'm very much excited this morning to join once more this week of spiritual festivity. How about you, Christine?
I'm very much excited. Now is day two. And guess what? Today's topic will be a very relevant topic because each and every one of us will be related to it. But what happened during day one, sir?
Day one focuses on relationship, on family. In fact, the family is one of the center of destruction for Satan, especially on the issue of broken family. Tin, I have to admit, I'm part of a broken family.
You are?
Yes. And I have experienced what others experience regarding being low self-esteem, being a little bit angry with my father who have left us when I was grade six. But I thank the week of prayer. I thank my teachers then. I thank my fellow students then because through their encouragement, I was able to make it. And here I am, a teacher of AUP.
So you didn't make the excuse of having or being in a broken family as an excuse to be a failure?
No, because I believe, just like our theme, being heirs of God's throne, we ought to be positive always in life.
And for that, Sir Ferdy, you have an A.
Yes.
If I will be a teacher, you'll have an A. For day two PM session, I believe that it is for each and every one of us once more because it was emphasized that courtship is not our work, it's God's work. And the preferences, our list, is not merely an human list, it's God's list.
Yeah, so therefore, Tintin, wait for the time and pray for him. Close quote.
I remember what the speaker said. He said, wrap the gifts and open it up till marriage.
Amen. I look forward for that. What about for today? What do we expect?
Wow. Today, sit back, everyone. Get a grip of yourself. Because today, yes, today, now, we'll be talking about sibling relationship.
Yes, sibling relationship is one of the important topics that this week of prayer will emphasize. Take note. Have you ever experienced, dear friends, that in your family, the eldest, the middle one, the youngest, at times there is that little rivalry, little jealousy, little, hey, dad or mom is unfair. How come she has a bigger, gift or bigger amount of money given?
Why are there kids who are spoiled? And sometimes in that issue, we could also include the word favoritism.
Yes. So before we part, we would like to encourage you that as heirs of God's heaven, let us remember to develop character. According to the Book of Education, page 223, in the third paragraph, it says, character building is the most important work ever entrusted to human beings.
Most important, sir.
Yes. So therefore, as we have our week of prayer, I would like to invite everyone to really take time to reflect on God's word, especially coming from our speakers.
Indeed, let's not waste every opportunity to dig into the Lord's manna this morning. Once more, good morning.
And welcome to all of you, especially for our week of prayer. God bless each one of us.
To open our worship this morning, please stand and sing with us our theme song, Into God's Family.
Synthesize natin yung kahapon, and then today, I believe that's the most important part.
Into God's family we now reside. Into God's family His love will abide. Looking to Jesus our comfort and home, waiting and watching for Christ's soon return. Led by His Spirit, we're heirs of God. Brothers and sisters through Jesus' blood, living united in truth and love, we're sharing the blessings from God above. Into God's family we now reside. Into God's family His love will abide. Looking to Jesus for comfort and home, waiting and watching for Christ's soon return. A family that prays in togetherness, sure of Christ's guidance and happiness. The home that stays true is God's delight. Committed us one, we will share the light. Into God's family we now reside. Into God's family His love will abide. Looking to Jesus for comfort and home, waiting and watching for Christ's soon return.
I'm so glad.
Into God's family we now reside.
I've been watching.
Into God's family His love will abide. Looking to Jesus our comfort and home,
for I'm
waiting and watching for Christ to return. For I'm part of the family of God.
The prayer thought for this morning is found in the book of The Prayer is the Answer. When someone complains of a devotional life that has gone sore, the reason is that he has failed to get involved in outreach and ministry to others. In order to have a healthy prayer life, we must be involved in Christian service. The two always go together. To pray and work is an important condition for answered prayer. Our prayer focus for this morning is to all missionaries locally and worldwide. So let me tell you the sequence of the season of prayer. First, we will kneel down and the song leader will lead a song to tune our hearts in the atmosphere of prayer. Then the congregation is given 3 minutes to pray. After which, a song will be sung once more, indicating that the time is up. Lastly, Ma'am Precious Tayaben will conclude the prayer. So to those who are able to kneel, let's kneel down. the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. 'Twas blind, but now I see. Servant, humble and meek, Lord, let me lift up those who are weak, and made a prayer of my heart always be. A servant, make me a servant, make me a servant today.
Almighty Father, great is your faithfulness. This morning we pray especially for your missionaries who are serving here and abroad. We pray, dear Father, that your special blessings be upon them. Please open to them many doors for the gospel, and may the Holy Spirit sustain, inspire, and enlighten them as they share the love of Christ. We also pray that may your protection be upon them. Shield them and their families from dangers, from sickness, from accidents and persecution. And in times when they experience discouragement and disappointment, may your love and your promises keep them hopeful and give them determination to glorify you, whatever the cost. We are also praying for each member of this community. May you instill and renew a missionary spirit in each of our hearts. Help us, Lord, to see and understand the needs of others. Teach us to serve with joyful hearts and to love others unconditionally. And make us your witnesses of your loving kindness and your goodness. Thank you, Lord, for hearing our prayer. We are asking all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
I don't know when it will be, that day that I go to that land.
I don't know the day nor the time that the suffering will be ended.
The disappointment and all of the suffering they have taken away, the hardness of their heart,
so they
will be there so there will not be disappointment. My happiness will be eternal with God. Angels are around, praising our God, showing the joy of being there. In the place that I am longing for.
Step by step, I will reach that place. nothing will hold me from reaching that place to Canaan.
Not a place,
not a place. My happiness will be eternal with God. Angels around, praising your God, showing the joy of being there in that place that I am longing for.
Good morning, PIC. Good morning, fellow heirs of Christ. How are you? Thank you for that answer. How about the gentleman? How are you? Have you been blessed by yesterday's messages? Praise God. And as we continue in this week of our spiritual emphasis, I would like you to continually pray for the Holy Spirit to dwell upon your heart and to your soul. And as we continue, I ask everyone to please kneel with me as we seek the Lord in prayer. Most gracious, kind Heavenly Father, good morning, Lord. I exalt your name on high at this very moment, Lord. I praise you, for you have created me just as I am. And as I speak to your people, please do guide me. I am a sinner, O God. Hide me on the cross and deliver me from this. May the listeners have an open mind, and may the Holy Spirit speak to their soul. May I be your mouthpiece in this hour, and forgive me for all of the sins that I have committed against thee. For this I ask, in the loving name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. The topic that God asked me to deliver to you is about our relationship. Our relationship within our home. Perhaps many of you can relate to this topic because I know many of you had your own brothers and sisters. It's about our sibling relationship. I entitled this message to be the different to be similar. Isn't it ironic, right? You are different, but yet you will be similar. Before anything else, I would like to ask how many you here are firstborn son or daughter in your family? Will you please raise your hand? It's quite a number. How about the middle son or daughter in the family? So it seems that there are more middle sons and daughters here. How about the youngest? Oh, a lot more. And how about the only child in the family? There's quite a few. I did a research about what are the characteristics of these siblings. I want you to validate if this characteristic has been manifested on you, my dear brothers and sisters. So, let's start. Firstborn child, you are driven, achievement-oriented, conscientious, self-critical, approval-seeking, risk-averse, and emotional-intense. My dear firstborn children, do you possess this characteristic? Perhaps you will say yes, but not all. The second is the middle child. Are you really the peacemaker? Do you have really this entrepreneurial spirit? Oh, you are somewhat rebellious. Why? You are people pleaser and you thrive on friendships. How about the youngest child? The youngest child, these are the ones who are the spontaneous in the family. You are charismatic, outgoing, persuasive, attention seeker, self-centered, and manipulative. Well, I didn't put that all the positive. Well, you do have a negative as well. How about our only children in the family? Let's see if you would agree to this characteristic. Only child, you are extremely mature. Are you? You are independent. Creative leader. Aloof. Resourceful. Perfectionist. And well-organized. Well, I am not saying that it is 100% true, but what I am trying to say is, in some points, you do have these characteristics. As part of the preparation of this sermon, I asked a close friend of mine of what they think is the cause of the differences among the siblings. Some of them would say birth order, the upbringing of the parents, but there is an answer that really, that really made me inspired to write this message. The question is, what is the cause of the differences among siblings? It's about our dreams and aspirations. Our dreams and aspirations that sometimes create a divide within your family members. Well, some of you want to become a policeman, then you will act a policeman, like a policeman. If you want to become a nurse, then you will show the care. Did you get me? Our dreams and aspirations in life is the motivating factor in having these differences. The Bible is full of wonderful stories that we could use in terms of our dreams. And one of them, and the most famous of them all, who is he? He is the dreamer. He is Joseph. Joseph had a dream. Please open your Bibles with me on Genesis chapter 37. It is about the biblical account of the life of Joseph. Joseph is the son of Jacob to his mother, Rachel. Of all the sons, Joseph is the favorite. And you could validly find that on verse 3. It says, it says on my Bible that, now Israel loved Joseph more than any of his sons, because he had been born to him in his old age, and he made a rich ornamented robe for him. In the other translation, it is saying that a cloth of many colors, just like what I am wearing right now. So probably I am Joseph right now. See, Joseph is the favorite son. And God showed a dream to Joseph. Let's read Genesis chapter 37. When his brothers saw that their father loved him more than any of them, they hated him and could not speak a kind word to him. So when they saw that Joseph had been presented by a coat of many colors, they became jealous. And Joseph had a dream. And when he told it to his brothers, they hated him all the more. He said to them, "Listen to this dream I had. We were binding sheaves of grain out in the field when suddenly my sheaf rose and stood upright, while your sheaves gathered around mine and bowed down to it." What can you notice about the tone of Joseph when he is saying these words to his brothers? What is his tone? He is proud. He boasts himself, my dear brothers and sisters. "See, I have a coat of many colors, and I have this dream of mine, and you do not have yours." Yes, God showed a dream to Joseph. He blessed him with his dream. However, Joseph exalted himself to his brothers. Even his brothers was astonished with his dream of him. This proud heart of him made him into the pit of his envy brothers. See, my dear brothers and sisters, being proud is not good. Joseph is a handsome man, I suppose. So, dear gentlemen, I know that like me, you are handsome too. So, you have to guard your thoughts. You have not to boast your handsomeness, your greatness. And for ladies, your outward beauty or even your inward beauty could bring you to danger if you misapply it. You have to maximize your potential and make yourself available for him. Yes, you have this difference among your siblings, but what I am trying to say is, use it for the glory of God. If you're good at academics, then be of help to those person who doesn't know the topic. If you're good at preaching, then preach. If you're good at singing, then sing for God. Dare to stand with God for God. The second thing that I want to point out is when his brother developed the envy spirit in their heart, it's about our being envious. Joseph's half-brothers were jealous of him. Wherefore, in Dothan, most of them plotted to kill him, with the exception of his brother Reuben, who suggested to have Joseph put in an empty cistern and later would be rescued by himself. But upon imprisoning Joseph, they saw a camel caravan going to Egypt carrying perfumes and spices, and they sold Joseph to them. Thereafter, the guilty brothers painted a goat's blood on the coat of Jacob. Please read with me Genesis chapter 37, verses 18 to 20. But they saw him in the distance, and before he reached them, they plotted to kill him. Here comes the dreamer. They said to each other, come now, let us kill him and throw him in one of the cisterns and say that a ferocious animal devoured him. Then we'll see what comes to his dream. Friends, there are times in our lives that we envy too much to our brothers and sisters. We tend to compare ourselves to them. We tend to develop the thinking that because they are receiving high-value gifts, they are much more loved than us. Sometimes we are doing bad things for the detriment of our brothers. We became self-centered and we envy too much because we think that they are receiving much love, attention, and even favor. We should not allow these things to happen to us because we are made out of love and our parents made you because they love you. Let's have an open heart to understand the situation. Perhaps your parents don't have enough money to give you these things simultaneously. You just have to wait. Or maybe they are thinking that you are more equipped than compared to your brothers and sisters. But don't forget, my dear brothers and sisters, you are precious to them as well. Have you ever felt that sometimes your parents are pushing you to something that you don't want to do? Our parents do have an expectation. It's normal. Our parents do have expectation over us. They are after our welfare. Even the most neglectful parent has his own dream for his son and daughter. Even Jacob has his expectation over his sons. Let's read Patriarchs and Prophets, page 235. It says, one after another, the names of his sons were mentioned. The character of each was described, and the future history of the tribe was briefly foretold. Reuben, thou art my firstborn, my might and the beginning of my strength, the excellency of dignity and the excellence of power. The priesthood was apportioned to Levi, and the kingdom and the messianic promise to Judah, and the double portion of the inheritance to Joseph. The tribe of Reuben never rose to eminence in Israel. It was not so numerous as Judah, as Joseph, or Dan, and was among the first that were carried into captivity. Yes, dear brothers and sisters, we cannot live away the expectation that our parents are having unto us. But are you doing this expectation? Are you living with this expectation? What would your parents feel if you are not doing what they are expecting from you? Ephesians 6, verse 1 says, "Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right." So, my dear brothers and sisters, let's leave the expectation of this, of our parents, and let's continually pray for their plan for us. But my dear brothers and sisters, have you ever felt the burden that sometimes we do have this expectation, our parents, but do we live the God's expectation? Even God has His expectation over you, my brothers and sisters. Even God has His expectation over you. But are you living with it? Are you living with it? I want you to open your Bibles with me on Mark 12, 30 to 31. I know some of you know this scripture song, and I invite everyone to please sing the scripture song with me. Could you? Let's sing it. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your heart. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul and mind. You shall love your neighbor as you love yourself. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind. Let's sing it once more. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your heart. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind. You shall love your neighbor as you love yourself. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind. The verse says it so. You should love the Lord your God with all your mind, strength, soul, and mind. And the greatest among this is to love your neighbor as yourself. Romans 12, 6 to 8 says, we have different gifts according to the grace given us. If a man's gift is prophesying, let him use it in proportion to his faith. If it's serving, let him serve. If it is teaching, let him teach. If it is encouraging, let him encourage. If it is for contributing to the needs of others, let him give it generously. If it is leadership, let him govern diligently. If it is showing mercy, let him do it cheerfully. My dear brothers and sisters, are we living to this expectation that God is calling us? We can maximize our potential when we allow our natural giftings and inclination to develop and mature. God has placed in each one of you unique gifts and potentials, and we can find the highest place of our usefulness if we are using these gifts for the glory of God. My dear brothers and sisters, I want you to use whatever gift that you have for the glory of God. We need to get our inspiration from God. We should not allow man, the fear of man, to interfere with our missions in our lives. Jesus himself took the initiative when he go through his people preaching the gospel. He did not wait somebody to encourage him or push him forward. Our efforts must be undergirded by prayer. A farmer plows the field, but he still the rain to get his crops prospered. The same way, God's blessings can be only achieved if we have this fervent prayer with him. The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. We can maximize our potential by undergirding our efforts with prayers and intercession with him. So, my dear brothers and sisters, I know that you are dreaming, but I want to say to you that may this dream will not create a divide between your brothers and sisters. I know that you have different personalities. I know that you have these different gifts, but are you using it for the glory of God? My dear brothers and sisters, I want to share a story with you. There was a little boy who were born without knowing who his father was. There was a boy who were born out of this world without knowing his father. He lived up with his mother as the one being the father and the mother at the same time. Apparently, his mother was forced to work to sustain his needs, leaving him to the guidance of his grandmother, aunties, and uncle. This boy grew up as a dreamer. He got several awards in school, thinking that this recognition would help him to see his father. But upon reaching this goal of him, he became too proud of himself, just what Joseph did. He became too proud of himself. My dear brothers and sisters, there is a point in life that this man had a younger sibling. It was when he is 12 years old that he had his younger sibling. With this point, he got envied so much of his sister, thinking that all the attention coming from those persons who love him will be transferred to him, from him to his younger sister. He developed the jealousy in his heart, just like Joseph's brother. Later on, this man found Christ in his life. Christ spoke to him, saying, "You are my son. I am your father. I love you. You may not know your father, but I did prepare a good testimony for you up there in heaven. Son, I am in control. Just trust me. Show love. Be of an inspiration to those persons around you." This message really moved me, my dear brothers and sisters. Who am I not to love my sister? Who am I not to love my mother? They are the gifts of God to me. God gave me these wonderful people to remind that he loves me. He died for you, and he is willing to sacrifice for all sake. Yes, I am the child. And even now, I don't know who is my father. Even now, I don't know where he is. Friends, you are lucky. You are more than blessed than anyone else. You have a complete family. You can celebrate Sabbath together. But for instance, you know, my dear brothers and sisters, I praise God because my mother came here. This is the first time that I saw him going to church. This is the first time that I saw him, sir, going with me to church. And I am so much blessed because I am the speaker. I am so much blessed, my dear brothers and sisters. So, you, if you haven't say, I love you to your brother or sister, it is the time. It is the time. Don't create a divide between your brother or sister. Let not jealousy and envy spirit separates you from your brother or sister. Let God enter to your heart. And as you listen to the song, let the Holy Spirit enter your soul. Remove the jealousy. Remove the pride in your life that create a wickedness in your heart. Sometimes it's very easy to get angry with our brother, with our sister, compared to those persons that, who doesn't know you. But what I am trying to say is, forgive and forget. Don't let sin come into your soul.
This family, the family of God, do you know how sweet to be in God's loving family? Oh, such fellowship to be. Let us come and be a part of His family, the family of God. For when in Jesus we abide and we worship side by side, joyful singing without end, heavenly angels will attend. Let us love one another, every brother and sister. Come and be a part of His family, the family of God. Living for Jesus, abiding in His word, soon in heaven we'll be the family, the family of God.
I request everyone to please close your eyes. Please close your eyes. Please close your eyes. Let Jesus speak to your heart at this moment. Talk to Him personally. If any one of you here desires to be part of the heavenly kingdom for God, I request you to stand as a sign of your commitment to God, that you will not feel jealous anymore. That you will not feel jealous anymore. I'm not after the number, my dear brothers and sisters. I'm not after the number. But God is calling you. At this point, I'd like to call three persons here in front. The first call is for those who felt that they are neglected, that their loved ones do not love and value them. But I tell you, my brother, God is so much concerned about you. He made you perfectly just as you are. God is watching you over now. You are very much important to Him. You have your own potential. You have your own differences. But God is calling us to be similar in purpose. Use it for the glory of God. And if any one of you desires to surrender his life to God and remove the sin, the jealousy, the pride and envy spirit of him, will you please go here up front? The second call is for those who considered themselves as probably favorites, who feel ashamed to their siblings that they are much favored over the others. Jesus is calling you to be with him. Be of good courage to be on your brother's side, as you both wait for the coming of the Lord. Jesus wants you to be with him, together with your brother. Let him enter your heart. Let Jesus speak to you. Come here, my brother. Come here. My dear sister, come here. Jesus is ever willing to die, even if you're just one. Even if you're just one. The third and last call is for those who feel that the expectations coming from their loved ones are high, and to the point that you are about to give up. But Jesus is giving you the power and assurance that you will surpass the pressure that you have at this moment. Just surrender all to him. Just surrender all to him. And if any of you want to remove the cloth of sin in your life, let Jesus speak to your heart. Let Jesus enter your soul. My brothers and sisters, we are God's children. From our earthly family towards a heavenly one. In times our family on earth fails, we are assured that we have a family in Christ, and that by Jesus' sacrifice, we are the inheritors of this kingdom. So my dear brothers and sisters, if there is something that is hindering you to surrender all to God, repent. Repent, my dear brothers and sisters. Remove the pride in your life. Remove the envy spirit and let God take over you. Let God lead your life. And as we close, my dear brothers and sisters, let's pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, you have seen those persons who stood up for you, who had your courage to stand amidst of the sins in their life. You have seen that they are more than willing to surrender all this unrighteousness. Oh God, I pray that will you please use these persons mightily in whatever circumstance, this dear Heavenly Father, guide us with your loving spirit. Help us not to feel jealous anymore. Help us not to envy anymore. And help us to develop the character of Christ. May we become an heir to your kingdom. Oh God, I pray that will you please pierce our heart, touch our heart, and may the Holy Spirit dwell upon each and every one of us. Because we ask all these things in the loving name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Joyful singing without end, heavenly angels will attend. Let us love one another, every brother and sister. Come and be a part of this family, the family of God. In the family of God.